Good morning. Stephen Whiteside here with today's edition of Stock Market Timing Television for Monday, October 21st, 2013. In the pre-market this morning, stock index futures and commodities are mixed, so we are looking for quiet open at 9:30 Monday morning. Let's start off this morning with some good news. My mom's out of the hospital, and I can't say she's back on her feet. She's back in her wheelchair with a remote control in hand. She was disappointed to learn that they didn't have Netflix in the hospital, so she's back home binging on her TV shows, so that's good news. Well, if this was a school project, I'd certainly lose some points for being late. I apologize for that, but I had a rough weekend and really trying to get caught up on as much stuff as possible this morning before the market opened. If you had a chance to look out over the weekend, you might have seen the full moon. If you're in Europe or Africa, you might have seen the lunar eclipse. And so this is the time and place where I think the stock market will want to take a break and possibly head lower. You've probably heard me say this before, but news is noise. In regard to the stock market, it certainly is noise, and you really do not have to concern yourself with the news of the day to be a good investor or a good trader. I would strongly encourage you to do a little survey right now. Here we are, the stock market is hitting all-time highs. People are having a hell of a fun time, but of course the average investor is not participating in this rally. And so, you know, do a check. Check with your friends, family members, co-workers, neighbors, relatives. Find out what they're doing right now, because for the most part what you'll find is they did not participate in this rally. Now, this is a monthly panic zone chart. Down at the bottom of the panic zones, of course, where we've got a pressure zone, this is the time and place where we look for buying opportunities. And of course, when you're up at the top here, this is the time and place where retail investors feel most confident that they want to get back in the market. Remember, they sold down here when they panicked, and now they're going to buy up here when they see other people panic buying. And we saw some panic buying on Friday. We saw Google, for example, have a huge pop, and we'll get to that in a few minutes. But if you check with your friends, relatives, neighbors, coworkers, you'll find out that most of them did not participate in this rally. And so here we are, we're up at the top of the panic zones, but we're also up at another monthly target. So we've moved two up from where the market peaked back in 2007. We're two lines up on the monthly charts. So this is a daily, weekly, monthly target of 1750. We got a few points away from that last week. And so this is where we should expect the market to stop moving higher. Looking at indexes, just a couple of charts this morning. We had an inside day for the XAU. We had an inside day for the gold bugs, the gold miners, the silver miners. So we had a little pop back last week. And remember, this is a sector that has been incredibly hard hit. So this is not the time and place you put long-term money into this sector. And while we got a little pop last week, the pros are still not back in control. Next up, let's look at my five stocks, starting with Apple Computer. We're going to stay long the remainder of our position in Apple Computer until we close below 590.13. That breakdown point is continuing to rise daily. Our next target to the upside is 515.63. You can see that's where we peaked back in August. If we hit that target, we're going to sell a little more Apple. Looking at the CME group, we'll stay long until we see a close below 74.12. Again, that level is continuing to rise daily. Our profit target here is 78.13. That's where we peaked back in June and July. And so we want to take some more money off the table there. Google had a big pop on Friday. The lower channel line is currently at 877.97. And so I certainly don't want to use that as my breakdown point at the moment. I would use Friday's low of 974. If we close below that point, then I'd want to liquidate the remainder of my position. Now, if you were looking at the charts last week, you would have looked up one line, 906.25. That would have been your profit target. Some people might have rounded that down to 900. So you had an order in the market. The market popped on Friday, and so you more than likely got filled at the open. And so congratulations. I'd want to take some more money off the table on Monday. So if you sold some on Friday, sell some more on Monday, but hold the rest and see how far we can go. Obviously, we're going to use the 974 level. If we close below that, we'll get rid of the remainder of our position. But we certainly don't want to be there when the stock runs back to fill the open gap. Looking at Goldman Sachs, we had a pop last week, ran up, hit the target right to the penny. 162.50 was the high, and so you got your orders filled there, and you're still holding on to a partial position. And so we're flatlining here at 156.56. That's really not going anywhere right now, so a daily close below that would give us a sell signal on Monday. And last up, looking at Visa, we're up at the top of the range there, hit 200. On Friday, so you got some orders filled there, so we're holding on with the remainder of our position. And on Monday, a close below 189.79 will clear us out of the remainder of our position, and that level is rising daily. Next up, let's take a look at commodity ETFs, and no trend changes on Friday. Copper is still not going anywhere. We saw that pop in the GLD and the SLV last week. We saw a pop in platinum as well, but no traction beyond the initial pop. Looking at crude oil, it's down. People are talking about the fact it's trading below $100. No change in trend there. For gasoline, we're looking for a close below 56.41 on Monday to give us a sell signal. And for natural gas, a close below 19.01 will give us a sell signal on Monday. Last up this morning, quick look at a couple of 60-minute charts. We need the VIX above 16 before we get overly concerned. Below 1700 for the S&P 500 cash index. For conservative investors, an hourly close below 1730 will start to agitate them on Monday. For aggressive traders, we're looking for an hourly close below 1734.83, and that's the level I'll be looking at to short the market on Monday. Okay, folks, that's all for Monday morning's presentation. Next time we'll talk about the U.S. market is on Wednesday. I'll be back tomorrow morning to talk about the Canadian market. Thank you very much for your time, all your feedback, and thanks for all your notes regarding my mother. They were very much appreciated.